testing, shattered hopes and dreams adorn the floor. The face behind the screen has seen it all before. And the worst thing about it is there's more in store. Just another sacrifice to the lords of war. The royal family sell guns, the royal family sell bombs that kill the world's poorest people. The government sell guns, the government sell bombs that kill the world's poorest people. Sacrosanct march of industry, the sacrosanct march of industry does such strange things to people. The spectatorship of suffering, the spectatorship of suffering does all such strange things to people. Imagination alive, cute as could be. You could see the gleam of mischief in her eye, carrying a kite to try and find a place where it could fly. Hovering not far, she saw what was a spaceship in her mind. Too young to really understand exactly what the buzz meant. Bread and water every day, other than that she's unfed. Pressure applied diplomatically to stop aid. Reality enforced by the air and naval blockade. Back to her, through her blood flows Qahtan, ancient civilization, but its status has lost charm. She found a place to fly a kite in the soft calm. Some will say that her life was in God's palm. She heard her mother call, saw her brother fall. Didn't realize quick enough, stumbled from the sudden force. Flicker and a flash to the horror scene of death. And this is what happens when technology meets flesh. Shattered hopes and dreams adorn the floor. The face behind the screen has seen it all before. And the worst thing about it is there's more in store. Just another sacrifice to the lords of war. A caravan in Nevada, he sits twiddling a control pad, taking down coordinates, scribbling in his notepad. When he sweats, the headphones itch and irritate his eczema, watching scenes on the screen as they enter through his retina. Sick of his life, his wife and his job cause it kills. Sick of his father, sick of debt from the hospital bills. Childhood of computer games that learned him in murder. He wonders if he's better off serving up burgers. A small part of him love watching death from a distance, but that feeling numbed the way through monotonous repetition. Merely going through the motions like the robot that he operates. Depersonalized murder, victimless violence for the modern ages. Cold stare and tap of a button takes her only life. Instantly regrets but watches on as she slowly dies. Grotesquely intertwined via the screen that he stares through. A kite floats away but we will never know where to. Where to? Adorn the floor. The face behind the screen has seen it all before. And the worst thing about it is there's more in store. Just another sacrifice to the lords of war. The Lord lives in the third dimension, far from the theatre. Every now and again, whimpers of the carnage get nearer. Sometimes in his dreams, he sees the harm in disfigured like Dorian Gray. Can't see his moral scars in the mirror. Cognitive dissonance suppresses his pangs of conscience, rationalize it away. Everybody has their monsters, but he is not everyone. He is a parasite of life and carries within him a selfish song never sung. Believes he loves his children, is he capable of love? Lord of the machines that reign Satan from above. Will they justify what daddy did or hate him as they must? Realize their bread and butter left faces, faces in the dust. As the sights locked on her, he loosened his suit and tie. As he sighs, walls of fire were shooting off to her right as she died. He ordered fruit juice with some ice. A kite floats away, he admires the blueness of the sky. Oh, Lord of War.